Hi, I'm Kieran McKee. Welcome to my writing channel where I share my experiences and insights as an author and reviewer of scientific articles. I encourage you to check out some of my other videos on scientific writing. In this, my 100th video, I'm going to talk about how to make your writing more balanced and rhythmic by paying attention to parallel structure. Scientific writing is often characterized by sequences of words or phrases to describe places, processes, methods, or concepts. However, the writer must be consistent in using what's known as parallel structure in composing such sequences. The idea is to use similar clauses or phrases in a uniform manner. This often involves using the same form of verb, noun, adjective, or adverb consistently in a sentence. For example, the following sentence presents a sequence that is not parallel. We characterized the study site by identifying dominant plant species, estimating average plant cover, and the nutrient content of the soil was also measured. That structure fails to be consistent to describe how the study site was characterized. This structure is jarring to the reader because the flow of the sentence is disrupted by the use of inconsistent wording. In a parallel structure, the last item would be rewritten so that it follows the ing form of the first two items. We characterize the study site by identifying dominant plant species, estimating average plant cover, and measuring soil nutrient content. In another example, the verb tense is inconsistent. The samples are placed in sterile vials and later analyzed in the laboratory. Since both events happened in the past, both verbs need to be in past tense. The samples were placed in sterile vials and later analyzed in the laboratory. Now pause the video and see if you can spot the inconsistency in the following paragraph. How would you fix it? Did you spot it? In the second sentence, the first two ecological services are described using the action verbs protect and buffer, but the third uses a form of to be. A better choice that is more balanced would be to say that mangroves protect the coast from erosion, buffer adjacent marine ecosystems, and create nursery grounds. A subtle difference that not only contributes to parallel structure, but adds to the vivid imagery by using another action verb, create. Headings should also be consistent in structure. In this example, I've listed headings that correspond to plant life cycle changes, stages. The non-parallel structure includes two items that use plural nouns, mechanisms, and rates. To make these headings consistent, we can simply drop those plural nouns and instead use seed dispersal and early growth. An easy way to spot inconsistencies is to proofread your paper and find conjunctions such as and or. Read the sentence out loud and listen for a break in rhythm. If you hear something that breaks the rhythm, look for inconsistent words on either side of the conjunction and replace them with words that create a parallel structure. In conclusion, parallel structure promotes balance and rhythm in your writing and improves the reader's experience. Thanks for watching, and please hit the like button if you found this information helpful.